I got myself some logs to mill on my sawmill.
If only they were a little bit bigger.
One of my goals setting up the sawmill this time was to see how much better it would work if I actually built a frame for it to write on.
It's always hard to unfold these, but outside it's easy.
Well, it runs, so it must be safe. These two things are my log holders that I also wanted to try out.
So these drywall screws turned out not to be the best screws for holding the logs, because I just broke the head off of this one, so I'm going to use some proper screws next.
With the new log holders, I'm still getting vibration problems, but not quite as bad as before. Wow, this pear tree wood, it just cuts like butter. Once I have a flat side on here, I can skip the screws for holding it on, because it'll hold on here firmly just fine without. So far I've found the oak is really tough to cut, the walnut a little bit tough, and the pear is really easy. But what I've got here is a log of spruce. Now the problem with spruce is it's nice and soft, but it's very sappy, so it has a tendency to gum up the blade. And with a wooden bandsaw, I don't want to have a watering system. So I'll be curious to see how this one goes. And again, I'm running into serious blade drift problems. You can really see the blade being pushed upwards. I experimented a bit with adjusting the guides. For the very first time, I've actually had the blade drift a little bit downwards this time. And the reason for that is I put a shim in here to aim this blade guide downwards a little bit. So it appears some of my persistent upward drift problems are just that the guides are not quite properly aligned. So I'll take some of that spacer out and hopefully that'll work better. The saw's really been struggling with the spruce here. The blade actually gets quite hot, and you can see there's it's gummed up a fair bit. This is after cutting about four cuts on this log.
I get blade drift, the guide bearing here gets really hot, so it's really not meant for spruce. I'd need some kind of thing to apply a drip to the blade to keep it lubricated, but I don't really intend to cut spruce with the saw, so I'm not even sure if I'm going to finish this log. It seems to work a fair bit better right now if I just motor through it faster, which is funny. And some of this crap on the blade has actually cleared itself off too. So it seems like I was just going too slow. Well, that's it for this time, and it seemed to work into spruce okay once I actually started cutting a bit faster.